Welcome folks, this is Marcus for Wear and Tear, yet another YouTube outdoor and gear review channel. Today I want to talk about the Nitecore Concept 1, a very high powered, high quality flashlight, and I want to point out a major design flaw that killed my Concept 1 on day 1. Now, there are plenty of reviews about this flashlight out there, and it is good quality. Nitecore produces good flashlights. That's why I also ordered this one from China.
I have a great relationship with China.
Through GearPest.
In China, it's all about cloning.
I got it for an awesome price. Usually for expensive flashlights, I would not order them in China. I would use a local retailer, because in case there is a problem with the warranty, it's just better you deal with a local trader than you have to send it back to China. In this case, the price was so low, it was like 35 euros, and the local retailer sell it for like 105 euros, so I really did not have that option. I don't have money like that, I cannot pay a premium, especially on a flashlight where I'm not even sure whether I like it or whether I actually use it. Now, I do use flashlights a lot, but I knew from the outside that this would not qualify as a duty flashlight. It would be more like an EDC flashlight for me anyways. Now, my duty flashlight is the True Night. It's big True Night and it's solid and reliable. So the Concept 1 could never fill that role. It is a very minimalistic flashlight design. The whole flashlight is not much bigger than the 18650 battery that it is powered by. Now, I was testing the flashlight immediately. I got it and I was playing around with it. I did like the user interface. It really grew on me fast. And you know, you get used to the flashlight. So I was just playing around with it on my desk, you know, while it was doing other things on the computer. Now, what I then tried out was the magnet on the back side. And to fasten it to metallic objects, of course. It's a fun game too. And I actually fastened it underneath my desk. So my desk. And really, this shouldn't be an issue, right? I had the flashlight fastened like this. It was to a metallic part on the underside of the desk. And of course, I did some kind of movement.
But still, the sloth was unharmed.
And it fell. It fell like 50 centimeters to the ground. It did not fall on a hard surface. It fell on a rug. And it broke. And why did it break? Well, because it has a design flaw. There's a major flaw in the switch design. And if you look at the switch design, you have this metallic part that actually moves. It's like a little flap. And that actually actuates a micro switch that goes all the way inside. It's basically a part of the electronics. So this is a very highly integrated flashlight. No metallic switch, no mechanic switch. So they really try to save as much space as possible. So basically, what happened is it fell on the rug. Good at letting things fall. So it fell on the rug, just like this, tuck, fell on the rug, and the force was transmitted directly onto the electronic switch, and it obviously like pushed the switch inside. And then I wasn't screwing the switch assembly here, opened up this flap, and I tried to pull it out with a plier. But of course that didn't work. The microelectronic switch was just done. It is just done. So this flashlight is still perfectly working. There's nothing wrong with the electronics, nothing wrong with the battery, nothing wrong with the LED. It still cycles through just the initial cycling process where it shows you the voltage, which is a very clever feature, by the way. But then I cannot actuate the switch. I cannot do anything with the flashlight. Basically, it is done. It's out of commission. Now, Nitecore offered me to send it back to China, which really does not pay off. because I paid like 35 for this, sending it back would cost 20, and then I would get the same flashlight back, a Nitecore Concept 1, and I don't want it. I also don't want to give it to someone or sell it anywhere because I know it's a flawed design. I know no one can rely upon this flashlight in an outdoor situation, in an emergency situation. With this kind of switch, with this kind of design flaw, it is really something that should be pulled, in my opinion. Because it is a rugged flashlight. It is watertight, it is very solid build quality, and it's a tool that you would think that you can rely on it, but then a little bit of mechanical stress at the wrong point, at the switch area, can easily, totally kill it. And so I would definitely say that Nitecore didn't do a very good job in testing out the flashlight. I mean, they really tried too much. They tried to go through a very puristic design, minimalistic design, and actually the switch is quite nice, you know, when you work with it. Because many of the micro switches, like, let's see this, the switch on the True Night, you know, you always have the problem to find that switch, which is not a problem with this flashlight because you have a mechanical switch that you most of the time use. But if you had to find that switch in the darkness, that's always kind of annoying. So this protrudes wonderfully, so you always find it, you always have it right there, and you can also actuate it like this. When you have the flashlight like this, and you close your hand a little bit, then you actually cycle through the modes or activate the flashlight. So it's not bad. It's really, I understand why they went for a switch like this, but it does not stand to mechanical stress. They would need to add something that absorbs shock, impact shock on the electronic component that acts as a switch.
This flashlight is done anyway, so let me try to salvage the LED and maybe driver components. Maybe we also see what's wrong inside. Thin the material is,
and now you see the LED board, and there, this is the switch, and it was just as I speculated, it was pushed inside, and one of the contacts also broke, one of the solid contacts broke. Basically, the board is a bit damaged. Now, I think I could resolder that somehow. And then I think the switch itself should still work. And then maybe I could bring it back in a position where it is, where it could be actuated again from the outside. But still, you see what the problem is. You know, there's this flimsy little switch in there. Directly soldered to the board, and it has no significant support. Basically, the only support it really has is the contacts. So this is why this would not hold up. So this is where Nitecore would need to make a change. There's the switch again. It's visible. Okay, now we know why this design is not a winner. This is wear and tear over and out.